Hi, my name is J.S. Buenafe, and I'd like to show you something. Take a look at this. What the heck is that, you may ask? Is it an insect? Some sort of ancient cockroach? No, my friends, that is what you call a trilobite. You may have seen a few of their fossils if you've ever been to a museum. Although small and fairly insignificant looking, trilobites are far more impressive than they first appear. How so? Well, in terms of longevity, they first appeared during the Cambrian era, around 520 million years ago, and disappeared during the Permian era, around 250 million years ago, a time period spanning a total of 270 million years. For comparison, dinosaurs only lasted for around 170 million years, a total of 100 million years shorter than the trilobites. How exactly were these creatures able to survive for so long? Let me tell you why. Trilobites, of class Trilobita, burst onto the scene during the period known as the Cambrian explosion, when multicellular organisms really started to take off. They were one of the first marine arthropods, similar to modern-day lobsters and crabs. Their bodies were composed of a head, a thorax, and a pygidium, which varied in size among the different trilobite species. Most trilobites had a pair of antennae, legs that ran throughout their bodies, and compound eyes, like insects. One of the first adaptations was the ability to roll up into a ball at the first sign of danger, just like an armadillo. Some trilobites, such as ptychopariid, had notches in the rear that could fit into grooves on their head, forming a nigh-impenetrable seal against any attack. Others, like Carolinides, had slim and narrow bodies that could be suited to swimming in the open ocean. Due to their ability to adapt to the environment, trilobites lived for hundreds of millions of years, and their remains could be found on all seven continents. However, there is one important thing that you may be itching to ask. That is, if these trilobites were so successful, why don't we see them around anymore? The decline of the trilobites may be attributed to a number of factors, but the most prominent one may be due to increased competition for resources. You see, while trilobites were the top dog during the Cambrian era, their dominance started to slip in the subsequent eras as other organisms were adapting as well. Suddenly, trilobites had to compete with many different organisms, such as echinoderms, bivalves, bryozoans, and more. The numerous extinction events probably didn't do them any favors either. The first one, the Cambrian Ordovician event, wiped out many major trilobite orders. The second one, the Ordovician-Silurian event, wiped out nearly half of the remaining trilobites. And finally, by the time of the Permian-Triassic extinction, only one trilobite order remained, and they too were wiped out. Although the trilobites are gone, there is evidence of their existence everywhere. Perhaps you might find a trilobite fossil of your very own right in your backyard.